So we're sitting here in what looks to most people like a normal living room, and I think that's your hope. Am I not right?
Yes, this is the Children of the Night home.
Right. So at Children of the Night, why don't you tell me, first of all, what a child can expect when they come in through the doors here?
Well, a child's first going to get settled in. I mean, there's an intake that goes on the telephone where we tell them what's expected of them, that all the programs are mandatory. They have to go to school. There's no day passes. They can leave at any time that they want. They have to participate in the rec room. There's no coming and going. You're escorted when you go for your doctor's appointment or your eye exams or to get your hair done. We take care of the whole child. But it's hard work. We don't expect them to do chores. We have housekeeping. They are expected to make their beds and do their personal laundry. We have cooks, and they're not expected to prepare their own meals. We want them to focus on school, and we want them to be a child again.
So what we're talking about here is not a flop house. This is not a temporary facility. My understanding of Children of the Night over the years has been it's 11 to 17. Is
yes,
correct?
The residential component.
The residential component. How does a child qualify to become a resident here?
A child must be between the ages of 11 and 17, actually involved in prostitution, willing to make a commitment to try and change their lives and participate in all of our programs, which includes on-site school.
So they can come here, let's start with a child at the age of 11. They could literally live here through their adulthood?
Yes, we've had children live here as long as 4 years.
This is the Children of the Night reception area. Here, a child care worker is checking in a new resident. Behind the counter is our hotline worker.
Children of the Night, this is Jana. Hey, sweetie, where are you? Are you alone? Okay, is the street lit? Are there any businesses near you where you can go and wait? Okay. Can I get the address of the payphone that you're at? Okay. All right. Are you in any danger right now? Okay. Is someone coming to look for you? Okay. All right, sweetie. Okay. So we have a few minutes. Can I get a description of what you look like? Okay. How old are you? All right. What's your date of birth? Okay. What are you wearing? Okay. Do you have a probation officer or a social worker? Are you involved in prostitution or pornography? Okay. All right, sweetie. So right now I'm going to order you a cab. Okay? And we're going to get you over to Children of the Night. All right, sweetie. All right, I'm going to put you on hold while I order the cab. Okay? Don't go anywhere and don't hang up. Okay, sweetie? Okay, perfect.
The Children of the Night on-site school that operates Monday through Thursdays from 10 to 5 in our shelter home. And I'd like to introduce you to...
Okay, my name is Jesenia, and I'm from Seattle, Washington, and I've been here for 1 year. I want to be a therapist, and I want to be also an actor. Okay, I completed 10 classes, and yeah, I completed 10 classes.
Will you tell us a little bit about yourself?
I'm Yolanda. I'm from Miami, Florida. I've been at Children of the Night for a month. I want to be a cardiovascular doctor or FBI negotiator. And right now, I'm working on my independent living class, and I'll be finished with that this week.
And what do you want to negotiate with the FBI?
I just want that to be my career. I really like helping people, working with people. I'm a people person, so that's what I want to do.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Randy. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Las Vegas. I've been here for about 3 months, and I'm preparing for the GED, and I'm not sure what I want to do when I get older, but I'll figure it out.
Were you here a long time ago? What was that like?
Oh, yeah, I was here about 4 years ago. It was pretty different, and I was younger, and now I'm more mature.
How old were you when you were here the first
13.
Time? You were 13 years old, and how long were you here that time?
Like 5 months.
And what made you come back when you were 17 years old?
Because I have a daughter now, and I need to make a better life for her.
And how are you doing that here?
Preparing for my GED and getting my GED so then I could have a better job than what I used to do.
And how close are you to getting the GED?
About 2-3 months.
Oh, good for you.
Thank you. Hi. Will you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Hi, I'm Connie. I'm from Oceanside, California. I've been here for like 3.5 weeks, and when I get older, I want to be a fashion designer or a probation officer.
And what have you accomplished since you've been here?
I accomplished health, and I'm trying to accomplish U.S. history right now.
What is your favorite thing about Children of the Night?
It's really fun, and the people really caring and loving.
And what do you like least about Children of the Night?
School. But it's okay, because we need to do it.
Thank you so much. This is the afternoon snack school break at the Children of the Night shelter home. And our chefs prepare delicious snacks for our kids who really enjoy the food here at Children of the Night. What is that he served you?
Peach cobbler with whipped cream on top.
Okay, I want that one.
You want that one too?
Yes.
And what are you going to have?
The same thing.
The same thing. These are the Children of the Night computers that are in the day room as part of the afternoon activity after school and on weekends. And some of the children perform their homework. And some of them just practice keyboarding skills, and sometimes they just play games. This is a typical Children of the Night bedroom, and our children have some time in the afternoons after school to come to the room and organize their personal belongings for the rest of the day. They don't spend a lot of time in the rooms except after bedtime at 9 o'clock. Each Children of the Night bedroom features its own private bathroom that's shared only by two children.